Hi everybody, Mr. Campbell from Mr. Campbell Rocks. In this tutorial, I'm going to introduce you to Google Classroom. And in the following playlist videos, I'm going to show parents how to use Google Classroom. Well, Mr. Campbell, why should we listen to you? What do you know about Google Classroom? I taught in middle and high school using Google Classroom for the past 10 years. And currently, with the shutdown, I have 6 kids that are using Google Classroom. 2 of my middle school students are using Google Classroom and Canvas. So I feel like I have a really good knowledge base on how I can walk you through Google Classroom. At this point, you may have already gotten used to it, but let's go into some of the details on how you can check in on how your kids are doing, what classes they have, what assignments they have, how you can monitor what they're doing on a daily basis while they're doing at home school. Let's jump into it. Okay, when your student logs in up here in the waffle, you're going to see the 9 bar, right? This will have all of the apps that are available to them. The biggest ones that they're going to be using right now are going to be Google Classroom, Google Drive, Google Docs, which is like Word, right, for Microsoft, Google Sheets, which is like Excel, Slides, which is like PowerPoint. There's some other ones that they might use, some chat, some meet options, which you can look at all the other tutorials on my channel for that. But when I jump in to Classroom, I'm actually logged in under one of my boys, one of my middle school students. And he currently has 7 teachers, 4 of which are using Google Classroom, 3 of which are using Canvas. And so we're split between 2 software programs. Now, if I want to check in on how he's doing, the easiest way to do it is I can go to his to-do list. So up in the top left-hand corner, you'll see this little 3 bar right here. When I click on to-do, it'll bring up all the things that he needs to do. Now, this may not be up to date depending on how your school is running things. As my student, some of the stuff was done in class, but if we jump to down to when school started online, I can see that there are all these things that he needs to do, right? Some of them have been assigned yet, but some of them aren't due. We're in the middle of spring break. As an administrator in our building, we asked all of our teachers not to assign any homework over spring break, specifically from this past Monday to this upcoming Friday. I can also see in this to-do list what he has done. I can see what's been turned in, when it was turned in, and the score he got. Obviously, right, we're on a mastery-based grading scale. And so I can see some of these have not been graded yet. So that's how I can quickly check in to see how my kids are doing. Now, if we go back to the classroom, we click on classes, we jump into these classes, I'm going to be able to see how he's doing in individual classes and what those daily assignments are looking like in those classes. That will be in our next tutorial. Again, if you have questions, if you're a parent, feel free to reach out to me. If you're here, it's because you need help and you're trying to help your kids learn online at home. You're trying to hold them accountable, but you also have a little bit of empathy and you're trying to work through them through the process. If you have questions, go ahead and leave a comment below. If you want to, you can subscribe to this playlist and all the videos you can watch that will come hopefully before spring break is over for me. Again, I love you as a parent and what you do for kids and the support that you're showing. If you're here, that means you care about your child's education. I appreciate you, not only for what you do for your kids, what you do for education in general by supporting your teachers. And I'm glad that you're here. If you have any questions, go ahead and leave a comment again below. Thank you.